defensive front. Can they hold up?
It's Oladokun giving to Davis, and he is stoned. Troy Anderson on the tackle, and one of the best players in Bobcats history gives the football back to the offense.
We talked about the red zone defense, but defense for the Bobcats starts and stops with Troy Anderson. He does it all. Impact on that throw with just fatigue.
Now on third and seven, Malott lofts one, one-on-one. It's caught by Nate Stewart. Stewart's off to the races. It's a touchdown, 64 yards. Nate Stewart, the graduate from Bethlehem, Pennsylvania, transfer player from Akron. I think he might have gotten a break here. The extra point by Glessner is good. It is 7-0 with 3:28 to go. In real time, Stinch, it looked like Stewart might have been shoved out of bounds. We'll talk about this in just a second. His left foot. We'll take a look at that in just a moment. Bobcats on top. Nine. It's a handoff to Strong, and Strong makes a man miss, and he's got daylight. Pierre Strong, touchdown. 44 yards. That is his 40th career touchdown.
And great blocking on the edge to get him to pass the line of scrimmage. But what a move he throws on Trey Webb, trying to come up and run support. See number two for Montana State.
He clangs into guys, and he does get to the 15-yard line. Wait for the white hat. There it is.
And the Jackrabbit defense was ready. They saw it. You know, they were quick to the ball. And under center for Tommy Malott. But the Jackrabbits were ready. So look, they're all covered up. Adam Bach is right there. And he stuffed initially. It was that second effort.
5-yard line. Malott pumps. Pumps again. Gets the edge, and he's down at the 10 before the spin and the dive. It'll be fourth and goal from there, and here comes the kicking team.
Key stop, big stop by the Jackrabbits. Kay Tervier able to retrace. Great job. See him right at the boundary, number 94. Great hustle to keep him from getting the line to gain. Right there, he's out of bounds, and right foot, right before he initiated that spin move.
Blake Glessner to give Montana State the lead back from 27 yards, right through there.
This is the down and distance the Jackrabbits want to stay out of.
Dump off, what a catch by Kraft in traffic, and look at the big man go. Inside the 20, first down Jackrabbits. Oladokun, nice ball, and it's caught by Yonke, diving to the end zone, touchdown.
Oladokun's pass is complete to number 9, Jaden Yonke. Touchdown, Jackrabbits.
The Jackrabbits take the lead with one of the Yonke twins. This is Jaden, 13 yards.
And once again, nice protection by the Jackrabbit offensive front. Yonke starts on the right side of the formation. He's got time to come all the way across the football.
Quarterback, and your postseason quarterback is this guy, and he finds a wide open pick State sitting next to Malott. And Tommy keeps it again. They're chanting his name. And he's got a first down. Make it a first and goal inside the 10.
To the edge.
Moves two tight ends and a running back to the left. He follows him wide open for the touchdown. Malott shifts the protection, and they move to earth in front of him.
Great job by the front, and an even more impressive job by Jahari Martin. But watch the puller.
And it's a snap that goes to an up back. It was Tucker Kraft who...
Look at you see, Amandre Williams at the top.
It is a first down for Oladokun, staying on his feet down to the 35-yard line. Fromm's kick has plenty of leg, and it is good.
Third down so far for the Jackrabbits.
Oladokun wants to take off, finally gets rid of it, and Kraft breaks a tackle and gets the first down. Zambrano was there.
Maybe take a shot up top.
Extra effort. Touchdown.
Touchdown.
6 feet, not even 200 pounds. Playing high school football this time last year in Butte. Comes to Bozeman, says, I'll do anything you want for this football team. I'll block, I'll tackle, I'll catch passes, I'll throw them. Oladokun steps into it, it's intercepted. Picked off by Simeon Woodard. Is his fourth interception of the season, and boy, is it a big one.
Not necessarily the pressure. They showed the pressure, big game up front. Protection held up pretty good. He presses up in the pocket. He just doesn't get enough of this football, trying to get it to Canyon Bauer, it looked like.
Malott on third and 11, throws. Caught! Nate Stewart wrestles the football away from the defender. And Montana State's in the red zone.
Another 50-50 ball. We saw this almost exclusively from Montana State last week versus Sam Houston State. Once again, size advantage. 6'2 for Nate Stewart, fighting for his quarterback for the big catch.
24 yards to get Montana State back in the red zone. Martin wasn't even ready for the play. And instead, it's still a touchdown. Lance McCutcheon beats Gardner for the football. Some of the Bobcats offensive players didn't even know the ball had been thrown. Martin, look at Martin. Oladokun's in trouble. It's Hardy. It's Yonke. He's free. And he's inside the 10, first and goal, South Dakota State. Oladokun and the Jackrabbits need a miracle. He lets it fly. Hail Mary ball. Incomplete. And there is Tommy Mellott on the sideline. A lifelong Montana boy, overwhelmed at what he and his teammates have done today. Just brilliant.
Remarkable performance by Tommy Mellott.
Tucker Rovig gets to put the finishing touches on it. Merry Christmas, Montana State. One of the classiest people in football, John Stiglmeyer, congratulates Brent Vegan, and he takes a bath.